Yeah, I completely agree with you, and I think it's a fairly consensus view. Government bond markets are fairly rich, valuations are at all time low levels. I think importantly though that the mood and the will of central banks to continue to operate with ultra loose monetary policy, whilst valuations of government bonds seems low, I don't really see a normalisation of rates in the near term. I think in addition, importantly, that it doesn't matter if a German government bond is at minus 50 or plus 50 basis points. What you are seeing in a risk-off environment is you still see the typical mechanism, transition mechanism that you'd expect to see in government bonds and how that reacts. So I think rates are here to stay for longer. I can't see inflation or anything else that would potentially lead to a normalisation in rates becoming or forthcoming in the near term. So whilst I think government bonds are rich in terms of valuations, I certainly wouldn't be advocating being outright short bonds, for example. Yeah, so I think the best opportunities is within the corporate credit space. So when you think about the broad macro environment, you have this environment of low growth, but still positive growth. You have low inflation, you have loose money, and very, very supportive central banks. So I think that's actually a pretty decent environment for corporate credit to perform. In particular, I think investment grade is the sweet spot within corporate credit. Investment grade, the valuations are more attractive than relative to high yield, for example, and it's more defensive, which is important given that we are getting closer and closer to the end of the cycle. Yep, so the fund is really, it's a fully flexible fund, benchmark agnostic, and it's really looks to allocate the risk, the capital of the fund, depending on where the best opportunities are in the market, depending on where we are in the overall cycle. So certainly a flexible approach, but with a strong income focus. Just because valuations in government bonds are less attractive and somewhat less attractive on the corporate front, there's still certainly plenty of opportunities within that. As I say, we favour investment grade in terms of an asset class, but we also see other idiosyncratic opportunities in high yield and emerging markets. Yeah, so our duration today is actually pretty close to the lowest level of interest rate duration that we've had within the fund. So the fund will typically operate within a duration range of minus one to plus six. As it stands today, we're slightly over 2 years. So a fairly defensive overall position in duration. We still see some opportunities within certain government bond markets, treasuries, for example, certain points of the curve in various markets that we like and that we seek to capitalise on, but a fairly low overall interest rate duration position. Yeah, I can see why some people say that. If you think about European banks specifically, they've been very, very tightly regulated and they're being required to hold a lot more capital. So from an equity perspective, it's certainly a lot less compelling to own European banks than what it was in previous years. In the case of debt, there certainly are opportunities in various parts of the capital structure. Our favoured position is in the senior preferred part of the bank capital structure for banks. We think it's up in quality, so very, very defensive in nature. And we think it will benefit the most from EU regulation that requires banks to issue more bail-inable debt to shore up the overall capital structure and balance sheet of banks.